Hey, I'm Markia.
Want to hear something scary? The Curse of the Blarney Stone.
In Ireland, locals tell the tale of the lucky Blarney Stone. It's set within a castle wall that you can kiss for luck. But what happens if you disrupt a cherished tradition? On the first warm spring day after a long, brutal winter, Siobhan asked her friend Aaron if he would like to join her on her visit to the legendary Blarney Castle. On their drive to the castle, Siobhan couldn't contain her excitement to see the Blarney Stone in person.
"Remind me again what the stone does?"
asked Aaron. Siobhan explained that the legend says that anyone who kisses the stone will receive the gift of gab, basically eternal charm. You'll be able to sweet-talk your way out of anything. Aaron chuckled a little confused. Siobhan seemed really excited for what basically sounded like they were headed to some kind of tourist trap. Although he thought, that would be an amazing thing to have if it was true. Siobhan went on to explain how the stone got its magical powers. The builder of the castle, Cormac Ladder McCarthy, needed help getting out of a sticky situation. So he called upon the goddess Cleona to help him. She told him to kiss the first large boulder that he saw. With her blessing, he did it and was able to charm his way out of any problem. After that, he set the stone into the parapet of Blarney Castle. Finally, they had reached their destination. They walked across a long, narrow rope bridge to access the giant castle. But instead of following the printed signs to the popular Blarney Stone, Siobhan ducked into a roped-off area and stealthily headed off in the opposite direction. Aaron, wary but very curious, followed her lead. Finally, in a different part of the castle, Siobhan stopped. In front of them, set within the castle parapet, was a very large and noticeably darker boulder jutting from the wall. There was an opening about 2 feet in front of it. It hung over the side of the castle from the roof, and the fall looked to be hundreds of feet. Standing there, both Aaron and Siobhan could feel a type of energy emanating off of the angular rock. Aaron's eyes widened with fear.
"How did you know about this?"
Eyes gleaming, Siobhan explained. "During the winter, I did a lot of digging to find out where the real Blarney Stone was. The other stone is just for show, for tourists, but the legend is real. Quick, grab my ankles, hold me steady." She lay down on her back with her head hanging over the opening. Aaron gripped tightly as she scooted her body forward until her upper body dangled above the ground far below. Angling her hands against the wall for support, grunting, she hefted herself forwards and upwards, finally brushing the stone with a kiss. Aaron hurriedly dragged her back in and on his hands and knees looked down. Down at the ground far, far below. Extreme panic set in. He'd never been this high before. His vision started to blacken along the edges, blurry and nauseous as he felt himself tipping forward toward the edge. "Aaron, pay attention to me," Siobhan asserted and compelled Aaron. Immediately, he snapped out of it, angling to look at Siobhan with razor focus. "You're all right," and he suddenly was. "Back away from the edge," and he did. Aaron stood there amazed at Siobhan as she slowly grinned with self-satisfaction and turned to leave. Eyeing the boulder, Aaron made a sudden decision.
"If kissing the stone did that, taking part of it with us would be even better."
Making sure Siobhan was not looking, he reached out, quickly yanking a looser piece from the stone, put it in his pocket, and jogged after her to catch up. As they both rushed along their way out of the castle, Siobhan far in the lead, objects started falling over randomly around Aaron. A painting, a tapestry. Then there was the crash of a suit of armor. As he ran, he heard a voice repeating louder and louder.
"Return the stone! Return the stone!"
At the castle entrance, Siobhan had stopped, waiting for Aaron. Stepping on the bridge, he grabbed her to urge her to run, trying to get off the grounds to outrun the voice now thundering between his ears. Several feet out, the bridge started to slowly unravel. Siobhan screamed as the bridge gave, loosening below them and snapping in two. Their screams echoed as they fell. Something yanked hard on his foot, and Aaron found himself hung upside down, leg hooked on a part of the bridge, dangling above a terrified Siobhan. She gripped part of the fallen bridge, legs dangling. The stone then tumbled out of Aaron's pocket, hitting Siobhan in the face, causing her to loosen her grip. Aaron grabbed her as she steadied herself back on the piece of wood. Stunned, Siobhan blinked, Was that a piece of the stone? Aura nodded. You unleashed the curse of the Blarney Stone. It is never to be removed. Then the wood Siobhan was holding snapped. Wide-eyed, Aran watched as she fell into the water below, being dragged by some force far, far below its surface. Aran screamed out for her. His mourning would be brief, as a piece of wood that his foot was caught on snapped, and he plummeted down, head first, never to be seen again. As soon as his body disappeared into the water, the stone magically emerged out of the water and floated back up to the wall. No bodies were found. The bridge was repaired. An unfortunate accident, officials said. Savvy locals knew better, though. 'Twas the curse of the Blarney Stone, claiming more victims.